The first app I ever made was for a bar crawl for a birthday party with a friend. It's 2009. It was still just really cool to see your own name in a smartphone. So it had a little picker view inside it. When you shook the phone, the picker view would cycle through everybody who was there and kind of randomly stop. And I put a little button in the corner so that you could put your thumb over it and shake it. And it would, if you're holding it right, then it would come up with the birthday boy. Whoever's name came up had a drink, so you know, in the end we could set him up. It was good fun.
The first app I ever built, well, I actually started before there was an SDK. So in 2007 when the iPhone came out, there was a pretty good jailbreak community and we were sort of swizzling all the APIs. And I had been an audio developer on OS X for years, so I ported one of my commercial apps to iOS. And it was just super exciting because this was basically a full desktop operating system on a mobile device. So the first app was called iDrum, and we actually did 23 of them with different music artists and whatnot. And it was really exciting. We had two of them available the day the App Store opened because we had a pretty good running start. So
the first app that I built was called Atom, and it stood for the Alpha Tau Omega mobile application I built for my fraternity in college. And as fraternity brothers, we were looking for a way to communicate and broadcast messages privately in a way that was kind of like Twitter. So that's what we did instead of, you know, carrier pigeon or email or anything like that. We used this Atom app to communicate.